I'm still figuring this YouTube thing out. So
it's gonna be very messy.
I am very messy, actually.
Alexa, turn on beast mode.
Okay.
Alexa, turn on music. All right, so I just finished the workout. I can't really feel my arms right now. I don't know how I'm even holding this camera. It was hard. It was only 30 minutes, but it was hard, and I'm so glad I got it done and got it out of the way. I did only 30 minutes today, but normally I try to do an hour, but I have a packed day today. On top of it, I'm shooting, so I'm gonna try to save 30 minutes and quickly go make a protein shake for myself, do my skincare routine, and take a quick shower before doing the skincare routine. All right, I can't really hold the camera anymore. I'll see you in a little bit. As I said, I'm still figuring it out. Okay, I am ready. Just gonna grab my water bottle. My hands literally have so many things right now. I don't know how people do this, seriously. So I'm gonna go. My office is in the basement. So let's go work. The first thing we're gonna do, I'm gonna clean up my desk. So let me do that real quick. Looks slightly better. I don't know. Ignore the wires. So right now it's 8:23 a.m. and I have been up from 6 a.m. So far I have worked out, took a shower, had my protein shake, and got ready for work. My getting ready is waist up. This is like work from home edition. I'm literally wearing sweatpants underneath and I just changed my shirt. So the first thing I do when I log into work in the morning, I look at my calendar and try to see what are the meetings that I have today, and that way I can prepare for my day. And I like to color code. I don't know if I can show you, but I'll see if I can show one side of it. So I like to color code my meetings so that way I know how many meetings where I am doing hands-on work and how many meetings am I presenting in or talking in. And then I insert break blocks, which is also color-coded, and I try to do that like a week or two in advance, because the calendar gets packed if I don't do that. And that's the current way I've been like kind of like making myself disciplined to take breaks. I actually have a workout. The workout that I did this morning, it was also on my calendar, so that's how I stay disciplined. I put everything on my calendar and try to follow it to the T as much as possible. So now I'm gonna log into work. So let me go to my calendar. So yeah, it looks like I have a big meeting, one big meeting where I'm presenting at 9 a.m. And then I have a break, 30 minute break, where I'm gonna eat breakfast and get coffee. So there are two main things on my agenda. One is obviously get through the meetings. The second one is there are two tests. One has already been happened, an experiment. The other one we need to kick off, and the team is actually waiting for me to run the power calculation and give recommendation in terms of what are the sample units that we want to use for the upcoming experiments that we're running. And then the other project that I need to kind of wrap up is also an experiment. It's a lot of experiments going on recently. Is I need to write a paper and document what we found in the test and give recommendation to the team in terms of this is what your launch decision should be. I love experimentation work, so the days that I have to do like some A/B testing analysis or I have to run a test, like I love those days. Those are like my favorite days. So today is gonna be great, although I don't have a lot of time to do hands-on work. I do have like from 3 to 4 p.m. Allocated to where I'm going to do the hands-on work, which I don't know how much energy I'm gonna have later in the day. And I don't know if I mentioned this already, but I work at Google. My work primarily focuses on Google search engine domain, which is like one of the coolest places to be because I get to see a lot of like cool things. Okay, so right now I'm just gonna follow up on the power analysis. So I don't try to open my emails in the morning. When I open my emails in the morning, one thing, it's very easy to me get lost, for me to get lost in the emails. So I try to stay away from my emails as much as I can and really want to finish the task that I have that is like pending or time sensitive so I can get through it and then like use the rest of the time if I have free time on emails. And I have this communicated with my team, like if you need something urgent, you can send me a chat message. But on email, like my ETA for response is not within 20 minutes. So I'm going to take my time and go through my email box when I have free time during the day. So that email that I was just smiling at my screen because I said like I don't open emails, but I did end up opening my email today and I just saw a note from my manager. I did a panel discussion last week where I talked about my journey of being a first generation immigrant. And then there were a bunch of other Googlers who joined the panel as well. So there were about 5 of us who were talking about our journey. And then my manager couldn't attend that, but he just saw the recording today and he just sent a note saying that like, great job doing that. So it always feels great because I do a lot of these speaking engagements and things like that. And it feels great to have that acknowledgement and recognition for the work that I do that is not really part of my core responsibility, but like beyond that. So it feels great because I love doing this stuff. Hey, hi. Allison. Hey, sorry, I was just talking to myself. Okay, so I finished my 9 a.m. meeting, which was 1 hour long. It went very, very well. So basically this meeting was with my manager's manager and the entire team was presenting the things that they are proud of that they recently did. So I presented my win. It felt great. It's like human nature to focus on things that didn't go well, like specifically for like from company perspective. But I love that we have a dedicated meeting every quarter where everybody in the team gets to talk about what are some things that they're really proud of. So it went really well. I'm really proud of how I presented. Oh, one thing, I think I have been watching too much TikToks. One thing my manager's manager said toward the end, he said, we are into the thick of it, so keep up the great work. And the first thing I thought of.
Into the thick of it. Into the thick of it. Ugh.
Okay, that's a sign I've been watching too much TikToks. So anyway, so now I have a 30-minute break on my calendar. Let me just double check. I still need to finish that power analysis. So I think I'm gonna drink some water and then get to work and finish that power analysis and send that email. Okay, so as I told you, today is packed. So I don't know why I picked the busiest day of the week to record this shooting, but I think this is also best because then you get to have like the fuller picture of what it's like a day in my life. So a quick check-in here. It's 11:23 a.m. I have been working on that power analysis. Still, I'm honestly working in data. The hardest part is finding where the data is, and that hasn't changed. And I've been in the industry for almost 10 years. Like finding where the data lives is half of the work, literally. And then figuring out how to
source it and then do things with it. So 11:24, I have a 1-on-1 in about 6 minutes. So, and I've been trying to, since I've been sitting on my desk all day, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go outside and turn this 1-on-1 into a walking meeting. So this 1-on-1 is with one of my peers, and I love 1-on-1s because like we can have like very casual, open conversations without any agenda, just to like check in how things are going, what they have been working on. So I'm gonna go outside, take a walk, and then talk on the phone with my video camera off. I'm also gonna go, so I my office is in the basement, so I'm gonna also gonna go up and check if my kids are up. This is the around the time when they start waking up, so I'm gonna check up on them and how things are. What are they doing, if they have eaten anything. After that, I think I have a lunch break. So I have a 30-minute break and then I have some more work to do. So I will see you maybe around lunchtime. So what I'm doing right now, it's 12:14, it's lunchtime. But before going for the walk, I actually ran a script, which was gonna take a long time. But hopefully, since I've been gone for like about 45 minutes, I'm really hoping that it's done. So I'm gonna quickly check on the script. And if it's not done, then I'm gonna re-kick it. And if it's done, then that's perfect. And then I'm gonna go, okay, it's done, perfect. So let me save it. And then I'm gonna go make lunch and I'll take you all along. So maybe what I'll do, I'll take the meeting in 15 minutes, eat something quickly, take that meeting for 30 minutes, and then I have a 30-minute break. So let's do that. As I said, my days are packed and I have to be very mindful of how much time I spend on what. That's why I try to stay away from Instagram, or Instagram sucks me in. So I try to stay away from Instagram or any other social media, and having my days scheduled out, like, I know at what hour I'm gonna do what, really, really helps. Whether that is me taking a break, eating lunch, or going out for a walk, or working on something specific, writing some code, or attending a meeting, or writing a document. So I'm really good about my workday, weekday schedule, where I know what exactly I'm doing from 9 to 5. It really helps. Also, on that topic, I wanted to show you what my calendar looks like. I hid everything that I needed to hide, work stuff, so I can just show you like about the color coding that I was talking about, like how I color code my calendar to see, to kind of highlight and get a visible view, like a quick glance view of like what my day looks like and what I'm gonna be working on. So this is basically what I'm talking about, the color coding here. So the purple is basically where I have breaks. So if there's a break here, there's a break here. The blue is when I have a meeting, when I'm actually talking to people. That includes one-on-one as well. The yellow is hands-on work, which is I'm either writing code or writing a paper or doing something else. Then blue again, a meeting. Then purple is a break. And then this is a big meeting that is happening. And then rest of the day, I'm taking a break after this meeting. And then the rest of the day, I'm doing some hands-on work. And then the black one is basically, I have a do not disturb DNS. So basically, I don't want anybody to schedule time on here. So this is from 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. And then after that, it's basically rest of the day is mine. So hopefully you get some idea of what I mean when I say the color coding and like I pack out my day and stuff. So it's 3 p.m. right now and no more meetings. Thank God, I do not like meetings. Today was just a very meeting heavy day. Had a lot of discussions on things that we want to do and things we want to focus on. And then the projects that we want to prioritize or deprioritize. So as you can tell from my face that I'm literally worn out, but I grabbed some yogurt, got some water. I've been working on with a lot of focus for the last 1 hour, and I'm gonna finish a couple more things. Currently struggling with R, trying to download this package, but it's just not working. So I've been Googling the error and spending time on Stack Overflow. Well, I think you all can relate. Yeah, so how about like you tell me in comments what percentage of your time you spend like Googling things or on Stack Overflow? Because for me, it's a lifesaver. So I'm gonna do that for the next few hours. Not not to like Google next few hours. I mean, like, hopefully this error is resolved soon, so I'll finish whatever I've been wanting to finish, and then I'm gonna go through my end of the day. I'm gonna go through my email box because I haven't done that all day, and there is a pile of emails that need my attention. I'm not planning to work on those emails. I'm just planning to go through them and mark them if they are something important that I should read up on later, or if there's some action that is needed from me. So just kind of like going to go through my inbox and organize it. So I am hoping that I'll be done by 5, and then I'm thinking that I might go to my parents' house because they came over during lunchtime and I could not spend any time with them. And I feel bad because I was chewing food and doing my dad's stuff and then also running to work because I had a meeting at 1 o'clock. Anyway, I think that's like the thing, that once you become senior in your role, there are more and more people who would wanna talk to you, more and more people who would want guidance from you. So I think like that dynamic of your workload changes depending on like what level or where you are in your expertise on a certain thing. So as you can tell, I'm actually really tired. I could use a nap, but I'm not gonna take a nap. I'm gonna push through. I'm gonna finish this because tomorrow is a much better day from a meeting standpoint. I don't have a lot of meetings. There's like less than 2 hours of meeting, and those are like mostly one-on-ones, which I love doing one-on-ones, doing networking with somebody from a different organization, and then a couple of other one-on-ones with my teammates and other people that I regularly work with. But then tomorrow, a lot of my time is going to be writing documents. I have to write my performance review. I have to write some additional analysis that I've been working on, and I need to work on that. And then I need to send those out because I am taking off next week, and I really want to wrap things up. Pretty much everything that I'm working on right now, time sensitive, I want to wrap it up by Friday. So when I'm out of office next week, it's not back of my mind that I should have done this or I should have done this. So that's my priority this week. So hopefully I am able to finish everything. So if I don't see any of you for rest of the day today, as you can tell, like, I'm really tired. I don't think I'm gonna do more recording because I just want to finish the work that I have here, and then I'm probably gonna take a nap, and then probably gonna go to my parents' house, then I'm gonna come back and make food for dinner. And then now I just remembered that the laundry that I put in this morning is still sitting in the washer, and I need to go take care of that. So hopefully you all enjoyed that realistic perspective into my workday. Let me know if I should do more of this, or I should do less of this, or if I should do something different next time. I'm obviously open to more ideas. This is something new to me. I have not been doing YouTube. Well, okay, I have been doing YouTube for some time, but like not consistently. I think it's only about a month ago where I've actually started to take my YouTube channel more seriously. And that's why I invested in a camera. So hopefully you got to see good quality videos today, and let me know in comments if you like the video quality. Hopefully you all liked it. All right, thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to my channel, like, and let me know in the comments what you thought about the work from home life, or realistic work from home life. And exactly, I don't even know what I'm saying now. That's my sign that I gotta turn off and finish the work, and then maybe go take a nap real quick. All right, I'll talk to you later. As I said like earlier, I try to stay away from social media during the day, although it's really hard while working from home because like I'm not actively engaged on social media, but during the day, like after work or before work, I would try to like respond to comments. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go through my YouTube as well as my Instagram and try to respond to as many comments as I can. One of the piece of advice that I got early on when I got on social media was like, do not respond to comments. That just makes you look uncool. It just makes you look like you have a lot of time on your hands and you're not like cool. I think that's a BS advice. Like, that's completely bullshit. If somebody is taking the time out to comment on your content, why can't you take the time out and respond back? I'm glad I did not follow that advice, but I really appreciate all the comments and all the engagements that people spend, because as a busy person, I know like how important my time is, and I really respect other people's time too, because you took the time out of your busy days to watch the content and as well as like engage with it, because you can easily could have like just watched it and moved on, but you decided to comment and engage, which really, really I'm super thankful for, because that really does help in algorithm. I know I say it all the time, but as a data science person, like, I'll tell you, like, that does boost the YouTube or Instagram algorithm. I'm really grateful for all of the engagement that you do on my various social media platforms. So thank you so much.